Investigators have been looking into this case since the infant died on July 8th. News 8's Paul Merrill joins us now live from Waterville, where he just spoke with the baby's mother. Paul?
Yeah, Tracy, just a few minutes ago, Nikki Greenaway works here in Waterville. She says it was earlier this summer, the night of July 7th, when she left her three-month-old daughter with a former friend and co-worker named Amanda Heward. And Heward works here in Waterville with Greenaway, but Heward lives at a home in Fairfield. The little girl, three-month-old Brooklyn Foss Greenaway, stopped breathing in the middle of the night. She was rushed to the hospital, where state police say she later died. Nikki Greenaway says the police have told her that her daughter Brooklyn was actually sleeping in the bedroom of Heward's 10-year-old daughter.
You know, when you ask to watch somebody's child and you're an adult, I mean, that's your responsibility. I didn't leave, you know, my daughter with a 10-year-old. I left my daughter with an adult.
We have not been able to get in touch with Amanda Heward today, but at this moment, she is not facing any criminal charges related to this case. State police have been looking into this case for more than a month now. They just finally ruled it a homicide as of yesterday. Investigators aren't saying much about what they think happened in that house, but here's what they are telling us. State police say Brooklyn Foss Greenaway was staying the night at Amanda Heward's home on Center Road in Fairfield the night of July 7th over 8th. They won't say who else may have been home at the time that Brooklyn stopped breathing. It is the practice of Maine State Police to look into the death of anyone younger than 3 years old.
We investigate it so we have consistency on all children's deaths. In this case, there were some warning signs that we thought very early on. The medical examiners have confirmed that, and obviously the case now has been declared a homicide.
Again, right now, state police are not charging anybody with a crime related to this case, but they say they are still investigating. Steve McCausland, the spokesperson, tells us there is more work to be done. Live in Waterville tonight, Paul Merrill, News 8.